the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the feast of Saint Mark the Evangelist. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings and beg the good Lord for His mercy and pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who raised up Saint Mark, your evangelist, and endowed him with the grace to preach the gospel, grant, we pray, that we may so profit from his teaching as to follow faithfully in the footsteps of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, clothe yourselves with humility in your dealings with one another, for God opposes the proud but bestows favor on the humble. So humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your worries upon him, because he cares for you. Be sober and vigilant. Your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in faith, knowing that your brothers and sisters throughout the world undergo the same sufferings. The God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory through Christ Jesus, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you after you have suffered a little. To him be dominion forever. Amen. I write you this briefly through Silvanus, whom I consider a faithful brother, exhorting you and testifying that this is the true grace of God. Remain firm in it. The chosen one at Babylon sends you greeting, as does Mark, my son. Greet one another with a loving kiss. Peace to all of you who are in Christ. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The favors of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, my kindness is established forever. In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The heavens proclaim your wonders, O Lord, and your faithfulness in the assembly of the holy ones. For who in the skies can rank with the Lord? Who is the Lord among the sons of God?
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Blessed the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name, they rejoice all the day, and through your justice, they are exalted.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Please stand.
Proclaim Christ crucified. He is the power of God and the wisdom of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus appeared to the 11 and said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover." Then the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We all know very well, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Gospels are the treasury of the teachings of Jesus. Dito po tayo natututo ng mga bagay, paano maging mabuti, paano tayo magpatawad, paano magdasal, paano magpatuloy sa buhay po natin araw-araw, and maybe a lot more things that we all know and can take out from the Gospels that we hear every Sunday and every day that we celebrate the Holy Mass. But you know, I think more than this, as the Gospels are teaching us something, the Gospels also wish us our wellness. They wish us well. When the Lord taught His disciples to forgive, to pray, to fight temptations and all, He wished them, at the bottom line of everything, to wish them well. When the evangelists, Matthew, Luke, John, and Mark, which we all celebrate today, wrote the Gospels, more than relaying unto us the words or the teachings of Jesus, they wish us to see what is inside the heart of the Lord Himself. And that is to say, to wish us well, na maging maayos at mabuti ang buhay natin sa mundo at sa araw-araw. The first letter of Peter, our first reading, made mention of a lot of habilin to the first Christian community. But towards the end, he made mention of the person of Mark, sending his greeting and wishes to the community. After enumerating the do's and the don'ts, the things that you may need to spare yourselves with, there is someone in the person of Mark, someone wishing them well and greetings. When the Lord sent His disciples to their own mission, He sent them not only with a mandate, but a heart that wished them well. And that heart that wished them well, narinig po natin, they were able to experience. They were sent forth to mission. The Lord worked with them. The Lord made true His promises for them. My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, let it also be a good news when we wish others well. Let wishing others well be gospel to them as well. Kailangan nating matuto, kailangan nating ng mga pamantayan po sa buhay na ito. Kailangan natin ng mga tinatawag nga nating corrective measures. But let us also, at the top of all these needs, learn how to wish each other our wellness. Mabuting balitan na din kapag iniisip natin ang kabutihan at kaayusan ng iba. Kung wala sa puso natin ang mag-isip ng mabuti, baka hindi na po mabuting balita yung ating daladala. We may not really memorize much of the writings of the Gospels or the evangelists, but as we try to at least know a liner of the Gospel, accompany this with that desire to think of the wellness of others. Mabuting balita din para sa madami ang may umiisip sa kanilang kabutihan at sa kanilang kapakanan. Mabuting balita para sa mga tao, ang mga taong umuunat ng kanilang kamay sa araw-araw. Mabuting balita para sa atin, ang mga tao ang nasa isip magpasaya at magbigay ng biyaya. My dear brothers and sisters, we ask the intercession of Saint Mark, not only for us to appreciate the beauty of the teachings and the life of Jesus Himself, but through His intercession, let us wish each other's our wellness, and let that be gospel to us.
Please stand.
Mark proclaimed the good news of the true Messiah, Jesus the Christ. Let us ask the Father to hear our intentions for a world in need of the hope of the gospel. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be a living sign of true concern and dedicated care for those who are rejected by our society, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who wandered away from the paths of righteousness may hear the voice of Christ, the Good Shepherd, calling them home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may hear the voice of our Lord, calling them to conversion and to a life of service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who are suffering or sick may realize that they are loved by God through the care and attention we give them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may pass through the gate of the shepherd and rejoice with the shepherd and guardian of their souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord as well all the intentions offered in this Mass. We continue to lift up to the Lord our prayers for one another. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, assisted by the prayers of Saint Mark, faithful herald of the gospel, we bring our intentions before you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we venerate the glory of Saint Mark, we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of praise and humbly beseech you that your church may always persevere in the preaching of the gospel through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please still.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Mark, and who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in the faith of the gospel which Saint Mark proclaimed, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who has granted you to stand firm on apostolic foundations, graciously bless you through the glorious merits of the Holy Apostle Mark forever and ever.
Amen.
And may He who endowed you with the teaching and example, and His example, make you under their protection witnesses to the truth before all, forever and ever.
Amen.
So that through the intercession of Saint Mark, you may inherit the eternal homeland, for by their preaching you possess firmness of faith forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.